Now I would like to introduce you to MATLAB with this interesting circuit. Let's first take a close look at the circuit. In this particular example, we have a lot of resistors in series and parallel. If we wanted to calculate the total resistance, we can see that we have R4 and R5 in parallel here, in series with R3. That whole combination is in parallel with R2, which is in series with R1 and R6. MATLAB is going to make it easy for us to calculate that. Let's bring up a MATLAB window, and I'm actually going to open a new MATLAB screen right here. Let's give it a comment, and let's say calculate the total resistance. The first thing that I'm going to do is define my variables. So R1 is equal to 1 kiloohm, and to make it kiloohm, I'm going to say e to the 3, which means it's being multiplied by 10 to the third. Units for resistance are in ohms. R2 is equal to 10K. R3 is equal to 1.5K. Why don't you program this along with me? R4 is equal to 2.2K. R5 is equal to 4.7K, and R6 is equal to 3.3K. Okay, now let's calculate our total resistance. And I'm going to do that in pieces. The reason I'll do it in pieces is it's just easier to have lots of small variables instead of trying to program this all with carefully being sure that I've got one equation doing the whole thing. So let's calculate R4 and 5. That's going to be R4 in parallel with R5. That's R4 times R5 divided by their sum. MATLAB is case sensitive, so make sure that if you defined your variables with capital letters, that you're also using them with capital letters here. So this is R4 in parallel with R5. Now let's put R3 in series with this. So R345 is R3 plus R45, and this is, let's make a comment, R3 plus R4 in parallel with R5. Now let's put these in parallel with R2. R2345 is going to be R2 in parallel with, so it's multiplied by R345 divided by the sum. Again, making sure that I have everything in capitals, and I'm again keeping track of what I'm doing. You can use cut and paste in MATLAB, same as you can in Word. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now what I'm going to do is put R1 in series with this, and let's put R6 in series with that. And so this is R1 plus R6. Okay, now I have typed all of these things together. The other thing I'm going to do is clear all of my screen. Okay, got that. Now let's run this. See this run button right there? Let's click it. It's going to ask me what to call this, and I'm going to call it homework 1-2, oh, I don't know, B. And it's not going to let me save it because I put a space in there, so let's change it with an underscore. Alright, now it saved it, and look what it did. It gave me, it actually in this command window down here at the bottom, it printed everything out as it went. So up here at the top where I started, it printed out R1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, etc. It also put the variables over here. That's really where I like to look at them. If I didn't want them to print out, and often it's handy if they don't, I would just put semicolons on the end of all the variables that I do not want to print out in my command window. They'll still show up over here in the variable space, but let's make it so that these things don't all print out. The biggest thing it does is slows your code down, which isn't a big deal for a code that's this small, but later you'll find that important. Okay, let's run it again. Okay, it didn't print anything out, it just told me what I ran, but I can see the variables over here in the command window, and my total combined resistance is 6.6 times 10 to the third. That's 6.6K. What about the extra here that's 6.068? That's just from a little bit of error because we are dividing by numbers that are not exactly, computer numbers are not exactly like total real values.